Aloha, I'm Patrick Ching, and thank you for joining me on a special Christmas edition of Painting in Paradise.
In this episode, we'll revisit a historic painting lesson at Aikahi School featuring Santa, his sleigh, and reindeer too. Then we'll talk about painting coconuts with Lexi Robinson and join in on a coconut painting party in Aina Haina. Then it's back to Aikahi for a coconut gift painting session with the fifth graders and Elvis Santa. Finally, we see how my old horse Kimo got his Palomino Christmas coat. Enjoy all this and more on a very merry episode of
Painting in Paradise!
Now let's visit some memories of Christmas past as we painted Santa and a reindeer at Aikahi School. You can learn how to draw Santa's sleigh and reindeer on my YouTube channel.
If you can do one reindeer, you can do eight or nine.
First, we put the paint on the palette. Then came up with our designs. Just when we were about done. Everyone was so happy Santa came by. After all, they were all painting him.
Rudolph's red nose in your picture. And Santa's red hat. Thank you. Oh, oh, oh.
Since Santa was such a good art critic, I asked him if he'd paint something up for us real quick.
Oh, what you got? That's beautiful.
5 seconds. I could do better with more time.
Yeah, I know, but it looks pretty decent.
What do you think? Boys and girls? Is it good?
Yeah.
When we return, we'll learn how to paint Christmas gifts on coconuts. When I was young, the first job I ever had was, you guessed it, painting coconuts. I painted hundreds of coconuts and recently came across one that I painted over 45 years ago that still looks as vibrant as it did the day I painted it. I was so surprised to see that the coconut hadn't even cracked in all that time. Coconuts make such excellent painted gifts, and here to tell us about it is a woman who loves to paint on coconuts.
Hi, aloha. I'm Lexi Robinson, and I'm an artist and love to paint on coconuts. I do all kinds of different varieties of names, like you can do it for trophy, birthdays. It's a natural canvas, and it's a great way to send to friends in the mainland. You don't have to box it, and it's a perfect way to send a gift for Christmas or any occasion, and people love receiving it, and it's very fun to make. So both my parents are born and raised in Maui. My mom's from Kihei and my dad's from Punine, Magiro Camp. And I painted this. Maui is open. Please visit Paia, Kihei, and Hana. This is our patio. It's kind of our place to paint and have a Painting in Paradise and Patrick Ching join everyone here as artists. And everybody had a coconut and blank canvas.
After a while, we had a beautiful array of hand-painted coconut gifts.
I painted palm trees with surfboard. I painted turtles under a coconut tree.
I painted the yellow hibiscus.
I painted a parrot fish.
I painted this today. It's a whole new in Hawaii.
I painted my dog Sandy,
and my sister painted her dog Prairie.
Painted this coconut. It's a reindeer. Malikalikimaka.
I painted a coconut tree in Hawaii.
Then Brenda played us some Christmas music while the women danced. So nice to create in an atmosphere of joy and sharing.
Coconuts make a really great gift, something that you can make and ship it in the mail. People love receiving it, just write your name on it to and from, as long as you have it sealed and shellacked and no cracks. And take it down to the post office and it's good to go.
And since we were painting on coconuts, Kala came by to show us what we could do with the woven leaves.
Now, a big space here. Don't call me late for dinner. We'll kind of through that X.
Special thanks to Lexi and Barney Robinson, who hosted this Painting in Paradise coconut Christmas party at their studio in Aina Haina. When we return, we'll paint coconut gifts at Aikahi School and get a visit from Santa, who sounds a lot like Elvis. Now join us for a coconut gift painting class at Aikahi School, where we'll be using coconuts as canvases.
Just lose yourself in a little world of fantasy that you create on your coconut. This is a coconut made for you to keep or give as gifts. I love to color. In fact, I just kept coloring my whole life. You know, that was my favorite thing to do when I was your age.
We were lucky to have professional artist Colin Redican helping us with our coconuts.
Look how good your pictures can come out. Who do you think did this one? Miss Ma. I like to see your eyes light up when you think about what you like to do. And I like to encourage people, as you go on through life, bring yourself closer to the things that you love, the things that make you excited. You know, what if you spend most of your day doing the things you love to do? That's wealth, yeah?
Then what to our wondering ears do we hear?
It was Santa Claus, but he sounded like Elvis.
Fixin' on the reindeer, pulling all the reins. Bells are ringing.
Then Elvis Santa started taking requests.
Have a blue Christmas without you, everybody. That'll be so blue Christmas without you. The grace is a red on a green Christmas tree. It won't be the same if you're not here with me.
He even played Blue Suede Shoes.
Blue Suede Shoes, I blue, blue. You can do anything. Lay off my Blue Suede Shoes. Hey, one for the morning and two for the show. Three to get red and I'll go cat go. Don't you? Don't you step on my Blue Suede Shoes. Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas.
All right, so Santa's gonna do a painting, and I know you work pretty fast, yeah?
Yes, I do.
Okay, you got 5 seconds.
Here we go.
Wow, that is fast. Let's see it.
I painted a Santa. He's having his hands up.
My coconut is poinsettias, and poinsettias are my second favorite flower besides cherry blossom.
Well, this is an Eevee bird, and this is the lehua flower. I'm going to give it to my grandma.
Reminding me of a certain moment in my life, which was, like, really important to me. You should always give and try to be grateful for everything.
I made a Christmas tree of presents and a store and some snow on a tree and on the ground.
I painted the Christmas tree because I didn't know what to write, so I looked at canolas and I'm like, okay, I'll paint a Christmas tree too.
Well, I made a little island and I kind of wanted to make it a little Christmassy. So I put a tree with some birds in the background in the sun.
So I painted a honu. It's my favorite animal. It's very beautiful, and I just wanted like a memory of it, just in case like they like go to a different island or something.
For my coconut, I did my dog. His name is Chewy, and he is the best. And I tried to get the texture of his fur, and I can't wait to put it in my house.
I did a pig because pigs are my favorite animal. I don't know why. This is the beautiful pig. It's so beautiful because it's a pig. And pigs are beautiful.
So my painting is a EEV bird, and I made it because I really like birds. The rainbow that's there is just for like an extra pop in the sky.
It is a sunset scenery, and it has like palm trees on the outer end.
I think it's pretty. My coconut is a sandman. I wanted to do the sandman because it's kind of like Christmassy and winter themed, but it was also like island-ish, kind of.
And they all had a great time painting their gifts on coconuts.
Painting in Paradise! Woo!
When we return, we'll see how my old horse Kimo gets painted for Christmas. Now we'll take another trip back to Christmas past and see how my famous horse Kimo got his Palomino Christmas colors. When I first got Kimo, he lived outside of my Naturally Hawaiian gallery in Waimanalo. It wasn't long before he became an accepted part of our herd. The thing he was really good at was making people happy. Whether they were painting him or petting him, he always brought a smile. This is my famous horse, Kimo. You might recognize Kimo because he has different outfits, different times of the year, like Valentine's Day or Halloween and stuff. We paint them up for all kinds of occasions. But this time I'm going to show you how I paint Kimo his traditional Palomino colors, and I just can't wait to do it. Now here's one of the most trickiest parts of painting a Palomino, is I'm going to paint his leg all white about halfway up. Then I'll start painting on his body color and fade it into the wet white paint. The name Palomino does not describe the breed of the horse, but rather the color of the horse, which is like a creamy or orangey color body with a flaxen white mane and tail. I usually get other people to help me paint Kimo. You know, he's been painted about 200 times. When I first got him, he was like that big, you know, and every year we paint him different 3-4 times a year. Then we paint him white and start all over again. But he is definitely a boy horse. As you can see right here, we're coming to his gentler parts. And it's a true friend who does this job. But I tell you, actually, I usually get somebody else to paint Kimo and conveniently disappear when it comes time to paint over there. But they know they gotta paint the whole horse, so they squeamishly start, you know, painting around this area. And right when they get to right around here, that's when I pop out of the bushes with a camera. I'm also giving the front of his face a little more white paint, just kind of giving it a little bit of a gradation, a gradual fade from a lighter color to a darker color. Kind of a star up there, and then I'm just giving him a little bit of shadow color, kind of coming underneath him. Woo! Okay, over there, now don't look, everybody. Then it's time for the finishing touches.
Alright, so here we are. We just finished painting Kimo. You were very good, by the way. He didn't buck this time because I have an everlasting magical supply of horse feed that I give him right around this time of year. Lasts him the whole year, yeah? Okay, aloha.
Thank you for joining me on Painting in Paradise. I hope you enjoyed our special Christmas edition. I'd love to see what you did, so why don't you send pictures of you and your art to aloha@patrickching.com. Merry Christmas!
Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas.